Preacher, that ain't got nothing to do, and you've told a pretty little story, but I'm going to tell you, you may use the word shirk it off or just brush it off your shoulder and let it run off like water off of a duck's back, but I'm going to tell you what the Bible says. He said we'll either confess him here or we'll confess him there, that every knee shall bow in the presence of God, and you'll bring honor to his name, because we'll have to confess him that he is God. And it all began with a fear not. Fear not. Call his name Jesus. Very, very simple story, very simple thing, but you know, you need to call on the name of Jesus if you're lost and undone. You need to call upon him today and understand that you must be saved again. So you know, the name of Jesus, there's judgment there, there's future events that's going to be happening today, but you know, what's the name of Jesus mean to you today? And what does it mean to you? You're out there and watching by TV, you don't know Jesus as a personal Savior, you ought to invite him into your heart. What does Jesus' name mean to you? A lot of people in the world today, it's just another holiday, it's just something else going on, and knowing all the hustle and bustle of the holidays that we get that, and we forget to give him honor and glory. But you know, they said to call his name Jesus, my Savior. Brother Jim, he's my Savior. He's my Savior, and he's the answer that we have today. So you know, he said he would lead them out, just like Joshua. You know, Joshua was sent down there, and when Moses turned him over, this is what the story that you have. I know this is not really new, but he told him, you know, and he said, hey, you know, take up the ark, covenant, you see it going, just to follow after it. You're going across the Jordan on dry ground, go over into Jordan land, you're going to take that whole land. They seen walls fall and everything for him. He was their guidance, and he's their God sent man to lead them out. And Jesus is kind of the same way here. He's God's son. He come here to die on the cross to pay sin's debt. The supreme sacrifice was paid, and they called his name Jesus. And one day, he's sitting at the right hand of the Father. He's coming back after his church. And you know, we'll either turn to him now, but you know, in this time of the season, I'd encourage you not to forget what Jesus did for you, what he did for the church, what he done for all the things that we have in our lives today. And I would just like to say thank you for allowing me to preach a little bit of God's word and be able to have the things that we have today. But I'm so thankful for what God is doing in our lives today. Thankful for our church, and thankful for those that are here. I appreciate my singing group. I can claim this group now. I belong to them. They don't belong to me, and I'm so proud of that. But you know, think about what the name of Jesus means to you today. Think about that today. If you don't hear anything else, or don't remember anything else I've said, remember that what he told Mary there, the angel said, you're going to call his name Jesus. And he told Joseph when he was born there, and Jesus was his name there, and that name had come from a common name that day. They made it uncommon. It's above a name above all other names.
Yeah.
Brother Jonathan, you come.
Amen.
I'm just thankful to be in the Lord's house today and just be able to share his word.